What is up, everybody? We are back today with another Lightroom tutorial. This one is by request. If you are new to Lightroom or if you just don't use keyboard shortcuts, you are missing out because this is a huge time saver. One of the things that Lightroom is so good at is taking a large group of images and being able to cull out ones you don't want to use, make your selects, and narrow that down into a collection that you will edit and then pass off to a client or for your own personal use, whatever that may be. I want to dive down and show you how you can save some time with my seven top keyboard shortcuts. Let's get started. So I have a set of images that I've brought into Lightroom here, and depending on how you shoot, when you bring images in, it could be a lot of images, it could be hundreds. And so what I want to do is start culling down a large collection into a decent size that I can work with in Lightroom. The way we do this in Lightroom is by using flag states, and there are two different flag states. You can flag an image as rejected, or you can flag an image as a pick. And by default, when you bring your images in, they're all unflagged. So what we need to do is go set these for each image. Now, the way we're gonna do that using keyboard shortcuts is using the letter X to set as rejected and the letter P to set as picked. So if I hit the letter X on the keyboard, you can see that it set that image as rejected and actually fades it out a little bit too. So you can tell that it actually says rejected. I don't care for those images at all, but however, the next ones I do like. So I'm gonna use P to go through and mark these as picked. And so what you wanna do is go through all of your images and set these. Now, when you've rejected an image, it is not deleted. It's still on the disk. You can still see it here. It just enables us to go into another view where we can hide that. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. One other variation on here that you can use is to hold down the shift key. So if I hold down shift and hit the letter X, what it does is it marks it as rejected and it automatically moves the selection over to the next image. I don't have to arrow over. And the same with shift P. It sets it as a pick and then moves the selection over. So that's a much faster way that you can work using those two keyboard shortcuts. Using the shift key in combination with X and P is a good way to work, but it is not a great way to work. And the frustration that I have with that sometimes is it forces you to work in a linear fashion. In other words, if you hold down shift and I set something as a pick and it moves on to the next image and I set that as rejected and so on and so forth, I'm working in the order that my library is sorted in. And so oftentimes what'll happen is I'll come on an image and I'll set it as rejected or picked, and then I get to the next one, like, oh, wait a minute, I need to compare these. Lightroom has a solution for that. So right now I am just using the arrow key to move around and navigate in the view here. And you might notice that, like, for instance, these three images are very similar. So I want to look at them all together to make my selections. So what I'm going to do here is I'm using the arrow key. If I hold down the shift key, you can select multiple images as you move the arrow over. And here's where your next keyboard shortcut comes in, and you're going to hit the letter N, as in Nancy, on the keyboard. And what this does is it goes into survey view. I like to think of this as create a new survey view. That way I can remember it's the letter N, because this one's a little tricky. And what this does is it just gives me a view of just those three images that I've selected. And I can still go through here and let's say, well, these are pretty negligible, but the first one's gonna be the pick. And I'll go ahead and hit X on these next ones, and then I'm done. Now, to go back to the grid view, you're going to use the next keyboard shortcut, which is the letter G. It stands for grid. So if I hit G, you're gonna go back to grid view. So I've gone through all of these images, I've marked them as either picked or rejected, and now what it's time to do is invoke filters so we don't see those rejected images. And the way that we do this is turn filters on, and you're going to hold down Command L if you're on the Mac. If you're on PC, it's Control L. And what that does is it turns the library filters on. Now, you can see these right now, no, there are no filters that are set, so it didn't do anything. But what you can do, there's a bunch of different ways you can filter images if you only want to see star ratings or whatever. What we're going to do is simply click on the pick flag, which is the first one that you see on the left. And what that does is it narrows all of your images down just to the ones that we picked. If I only want to see the rejects, you can do a different filter for that. And you can toggle that filter view on and off with Command L on the Mac. See, now I've turned it off, or Control L on the PC. And then that just turns it on and off. Okay, so I have made my final selects and it's time to go do some post work. So we need to go into the develop module. Well, I could grab the mouse. I could click on develop at the top of the screen, but come on, that doesn't save any time. We're talking keyboard shortcuts. What you're going to do is simply select the image you want to edit, click the letter D on the keyboard, and that takes you into the develop module with the selected image. And once you've done your editing and you want to go back to grid view, well, we already learned the shortcut key for that. It's G. That takes you back to the grid. Before we end this tutorial, I'm going to give you a couple additional keyboard shortcuts that make it easy to navigate around in Lightroom. As most of you know, Lightroom is comprised of these seven modules up here: library, develop, map, book, slideshow, so on and so forth. I really only use the first three, but anyway, to navigate around these, you can use a keyboard shortcut. This one's really fancy because it uses three keys. What you're going to do is on the Mac, you're going to hold down Command Option. If you're on a PC, it's Control Alt, and you're going to use the number 1, 2, 3, 4 through 7 to select your module. So for instance, if I want to go over to the map module, I'm going to hold down on the Mac Command Option 3, since it's module 3, and I go to the map module. If I want to go to develop, it's Command Option 2. If I want to go back to library, it's Command Option 1. So that's another little trick that you can use just to navigate around those modules. If you have any keyboard shortcuts in your workflow that you like, feel free to share them in a comment below. Speaking of sharing, share this video with somebody who might find it useful and hit that like button. Until the next video, I'll see you guys then. Later.